With regard to disturbance for this zone, since it's a very wet zone, you might imagine that fire does not play as frequent a role in disturbances in this zone as it does in drier zones, and that's true. It still is a disturbance agent in this zone, though. We're just thinking about a different time scale. So we do get fires here, but as you can imagine, they tend to happen pretty rarely because you would have to have an extended drought, maybe an extended drought over several seasons, to have a climate that is going to, or to have climatic conditions that are going to allow a large fire to take place. But because those fires are so rare, it gives lots of time for fuel to accumulate in the forest. So when fires do occur in the coastal western hemlock, they can be very large stand replacing fires that kill most or all trees in an area and essentially create conditions for a new early successional stand. The revisit times for fire might vary on the drier end of this zone. You might have areas that would naturally, without human intervention, burn every 100 or 200 or 300 years. But on the very wet end, where conditions would be for that would support a fire would be much more rare, you might have a fire return interval of maybe once every 500 to 1,000 years. So these fires are going to be quite rare, so that allows these stands to get quite old. So on a very long time scale, fire is an important disturbance here. But if we're thinking on a shorter time scale, maybe on the scale of decades, these forests are really driven by small gap disturbances. A gap disturbance is a disturbance that creates a small gap, a small opening in the canopy, where an individual tree dies, or maybe a group of trees die, or maybe a number of trees kind of scattered through an area die, but not creating a very large opening, not an opening that's large enough for shade intolerant species like Douglas fir to come back. But these little gaps that create openings in the canopy that allow shade tolerant species that have been hanging out in the understory to kind of quickly grow and take over and claim those openings in the canopy. We might call that recruiting into the canopy. So agents that might do that, wind and other weather is important. So strong winds, storms that are going to blow over some trees, especially trees in areas with a high water table, so they're relatively shallow rooted and are more susceptible to that. Forest pathogens, fungi, are often agents of gap disturbance. There are many different types of fungi that will kill trees in the forest, but aren't going to kill all of the trees. So often what happens is one tree may get infected, and then through that tree's roots, for a root rot, for example, it might spread to some other neighboring trees of the same species or other susceptible species. So we'll get an opening where kind of successive rings of trees may die over a period of years or decades. So again, it's not going to be something that's going to quickly, dramatically open up the forest. It's something where you just have these small pockets opening up. So suddenly in an area that used to not have much light, now there's a fair amount of light, not enough for a shade intolerant species, but enough for a sapling that's been hanging out in the understory to grow up into the canopy.